This is my Droid Turbo 2 phone that the battery puffed on it the other day when I was out in the field. And as you can see, the whole back of it's kind of puffed. You just squeeze it, it moves up and down. So when I was out there, I was able to order another battery off eBay. And this kit came with the battery, and it was like a $26 battery package. And I just watched a few videos on how to do this, and each one of them seems to be something different. So I'm just taking what I saw in the videos, and I'm going to just try and do it myself without doing everything that they did. So first thing I'm going to do is take the plastic cover off the back of this guy, and let's see if I can get in there and get it. I'm going to take out a razor blade and try and wedge up underneath the edge of this thing. So every video I saw, they're using a heat gun to get up under here and loosen the glue. Well, I thought that would make it really sticky. Looks like we can get up under there with the pick that's included in the kit. Just work around the edge here. That seems to work. Now everybody is being very careful about the charging coil that's located right here in the back. So we're going to pull up carefully and try and avoid that. There's the coil right there. So you can pull up around the phone. And everything's intact there. Now, everyone did the same thing with removing these little torque screws. And this kit came with torque screwdrivers. So I'm hoping this one looks like a little Phillips, so that's not a Torx. And that looks like a Torx. I'm hoping that they included the correct size with the kit. And they did. So there's two little silver screws at the top of the phone near the camera. Everybody was talking about how easy it was to strip these screws out. Well, I'm not having an issue with them, but I am applying downward pressure as I am unscrewing them so that the driver doesn't slip. So there were two silver ones at the bottom, two silver ones at the top, and the rest of them are all black. Yeah, these tools are slightly magnetized too, which is kind of nice. This is my first time attempting to take this phone apart, so I hope it works when I'm done. That's the purpose of filming it. See if I did anything wrong. And hopefully, I'm going to skip a few steps that I saw other people doing in their videos, which I didn't understand why they were removing the motherboards from the phone. Didn't seem that that was a necessary step. Seems like there's a lot of error possibilities there because they were removing every connector from the motherboard. So before I pry this apart, I gotta pop the SIM card tray out. But let me take these screws out. I think that's the last screw in here. So the kit that came with the battery actually has a SIM card ejector, which I'm not sure that's needed, but. This phone's just not even 2 years old. I'm like really disappointed in Motorola and the longevity of this phone. So there's these plastic covers here that need to come up. I'm just gonna pop them up with a razor blade here. Just to get up under the edge of them. Now I'll try that little screwdriver they included with the kit, little flat screwdriver, see if that helps. Goes. And then up underneath there are two connectors, which I am not going to remove yet. I think, yeah, I may have to remove those because those connect to the back of the. They just reach in there and pop up. There. And there. So both of those connectors are loose now. Move this chair closer to the desk here, and this middle section off that just popped right off. So there's those two connectors that just undone. And here is my bloated puffy battery. Look at that thing. Now you gotta be careful with these lithium polymer batteries because they can, if punctured, create quite a hazardous situation with flames. So there's this piece of tape here It has to be removed. I'm just getting up under the edge of it with this razor blade and peel it back. And the reason I'm removing it is because there's a screw located right there that I need to get to. And it's also connected to the back of the battery, which needs to come off. So there's the screw right there. Take these two screws out. So there's a little metal bracket right here that needs to come out. That's what these two screws are connected to, holding to the phone. There's that lovely magnetized tool. This little bracket comes right off. Clean the tape up off of it. All right, so what I saw on multiple videos, they actually went and removed all the connectors from this motherboard to remove the battery from the phone. I don't think that's necessary. The reason being is it introduces a lot of error when you're putting it back together if you don't get all the connectors back in. So here is the connector for the battery right here. I'm gonna undo that. And that just popped right up. And then to get the battery off, this edge of it, and just slowly wedge the battery up. Careful. Don't want to force it. Oh, little plastic tool broke. Another one here, though. And there goes the battery, just like that. So, this is the new battery. You can see how tough this battery is. Once again, very disappointed in Motorola's quality. You'd think if you spent that much money on a phone that it would actually last more than a 2 year period of time. So this is the new battery. And I want to make sure that it works. So I'm going to press the connector back in. And then get the little power switch and put it on. It looks like the new battery does work. Let it finish booting here and then I'll shut it down so that I can finish this. I'm not going to tape this battery in, I'm just going to leave it loose in there. I see it's shown, power off. I'll be so happy to have my phone back and working again, then I can recover the video files that I have on it. Alright, phone's off. Make sure that switch is still, or that connector is still on there. And then, carefully put these switches back in. This is the power switch, and this is the volume switch here. And they fell out when I popped the case off, so that's where those came from. Oh, looks like I gotta put them in as I'm putting it together. So let's carefully do that right now. So that one goes in there, and this one goes right in there very carefully. Oh, I have to flip that one over. Yep. And then we'll carefully put that case back on. And before we finish putting it all back together, I'm going to make sure that it'll power up again. And it does. I'll just need it powered up while it's going back together. Oh, what I need to do is I need to get those connectors back on. So I'm going to shut it down again. Hold on. Start off. All right, let's carefully get these connectors back on. Look at that nice positive engagement on that connector. Same with this one. And we put those little covers back in place. Oh, you know what I forgot? Little bracket. No big deal. Back in there, pop that one off. Pop that connector back off. That connector back off. Back. Carefully remove that so the little switches don't pop out this time. And put this little bracket back on. Let's get that screw started. So you don't want to tighten down one screw without starting the other screw, because then the bracket will be misaligned and then you won't get the second screw started. So nice and finger snug, nothing more. And then pop that connector back on. Pop that connector back on. I think this bottom one is for the charger. And this top one's for the camera and the lighting. Oh. Pop that cover back up. Snap it all back together there. And then we'll stick the screws in. Stick those little plastic covers back. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop the video here, and then I'm going to restart it so that I'll just high-speed the rest of it. What I'm going to do is peel all this adhesive off the back of the phone, put all the screws in, and then put the phone back together, and the rest of it will be done in a high-speed video so that you don't sit there and watch everything. But anyways, let me get this going, and thanks for watching, and we'll get back to it in a second, testing everything out. Okay, so that took about 10 minutes to rub all this adhesive off of here, and I didn't get all of it off the back here, but I'm not super concerned about everything that's on the middle back section. I just want to get the edges around the camera where the holes are on the cover. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some 91% alcohol and paper towel and clean all the edges I touched and try and wipe the adhesive off. And I'm going to take some of the Scotch permanent double-sided tape and put it around the edges that I have openings. And what this does is just removes your finger grease and some of the adhesive residue that's on the case and allows the glue to stick better, the adhesive on the tape. Oh, and I also need to put all the screws back into the phone. I haven't done that yet. So as soon as, well, before I finish cleaning this one, I'm going to go ahead and put the screws back in. So we got the two little silver ones that go at the top and bottom. So I'm applying downward pressure and just kind of turning them with my fingers just ever so slightly, making sure those buttons are still in place. Oops, I picked up a silver one, but I picked up a black one. So we'll put that one in. One of the little side holes. Another little black one. One of the side holes. The little silver ones are about twice as long as the black ones. So it is important not to get these mixed up. The two little silver ones that go on the bottom of the case. I love the fact that they magnetize this tool. It makes a world of difference. I'll probably speed this portion of the video up probably about 200%. And because I'm sure you guys are bored watching me put these screws in. It looks like this whole process takes about 30 minutes from start to finish. And the most tedious portion of it was actually pulling all that adhesive off of the... I don't know why they don't make these phones with replaceable batteries like they used to. It's really irritating, actually.
How hard would it be to design it so you could put a replaceable battery in like the old phones used to have? I guess they just expect everyone to upgrade all the time. Well, me for one, I don't want to spend $700 on a phone every 2 years. Sorry. Not in my budget to do that. I'd like my phones to last at least 4 or 5 years. So hopefully this battery that I got will last a couple more years, and we'll be happy about that if it does. If the screw feels like it's going in wrong, just back it right out, because you don't want to cross-thread it. That one felt like it was going in wrong, so backed it up and started over. Oh. Almost thought I lost a screw there, but found it. Sitting near some adhesive that was blending in. I'll finish wiping this one down. And don't want to over soak the alcohol, you just want to kind of have it moist. That way you don't get the foam interior wet, which could be a bad thing. I'm just going to take this double stick tape. Wow, this is some amazing tape. Line it up with the case there. There's a little tiny hole right here in the bottom that is, I believe, the microphone, so you don't want to tape over that hole. So what I'm going to do is put the tape down and then I'm going to use the razor blade, whatever I did with it, there it is, and cut that section out. Because you really don't want to impede the input to the microphone. And I'm just going to trim up the edges here with the tape. Do a couple pieces up top still. And before we stick this on, I want to make sure the foam boots, so I really don't want to have to take this off again. Looks like there's a little notch up top for some kind of sensor, maybe another microphone up at the top of this camera section here, which you can see the little notch right here. And then notch that out with the razor blade too. Off of there, that piece off of there, trim this,
that.
Slice there, there,
and there.
Pull that piece off. And let's verify the phone's going to boot before we go and put that on. And it does. So we'll start putting that cover on. Line her up. Press down. And we have a new, again to me, phone that I just salvaged from having to buy a new one. Anyway, so thanks for watching. And if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. I have more videos coming. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. And I'll catch you on the next one.